Prescription for the diabetes drug Ozempic have grown so out of control that the insurance companies are telling doctors, stop prescribing. Now, can you imagine the insurance company that understands that they have to pay for all the physical injuries that these women are receiving? They're so concerned that they're demanding that doctors stop doing this. Now, with doctors, it's a cash cow, isn't it?
It is. It is so disappointing to see this story, to be honest with you, because this shows that even an industry as corrupt as the insurance industry, and it is right up there, it is a bad industry, but they're looking at this saying, we're about to be in a world of hurt, guys. You thought you had the Holy Grail, you know, you can call it a gold rush, whatever you want to call it. We see the warning signs because we're the same folks that were, you know, covering those prescriptions for Fen-Phen. We still have that fresh in our minds.
I was just going to say.
We're not going to go through this again with you guys.
In the Fen-Phen cases that we handled, we had the insurance companies early on saying, you know, what's going on here? Well, we told them what was going on. People are dying by the hundreds of a terrible disease related cardiovascular disease that killed women in a slow, awful death, okay? So they did the same thing. They said, stop doing it. Now, we have already been on this show, and I just want to give you the playbook. The doctors who are prescribing this, all right, they're going to be brought into the lawsuits that are going to be brought against Ozempic. Here's why. There's jurisdictional issues. I want my case to take place in Alabama. I don't want to be in federal court. So what I'm playing is a diversity game. I'm not going to just sue the Ozempic manufacturers. I'm going to bring the doctor in, too, so I can stay in state court. So I'm going to sue the doctor because the doctor's clearly on notice of how dangerous it is. They're like in a frenzy now, just the same thing we saw with opioids. If a doctor is prescribing this right now and a woman ends up getting really sick, which they're doing all day long, every day, then they're committing malpractice. So it just gives it all. The doctor doesn't understand. They may be doing well, making money on the facility, whatever the weight loss facility. They may think, well, we're doing really well right now. They're not going to do well when they have to go to court. These cases, chicken's going to come home to roost here.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I actually just finished writing a pretty big piece on Ozempic and what we've seen so far from them. And I spent a lot of time comparing it to the Fen-Phen days. So what's happening right now, obviously, and we talked about this, we've talked about it with Cameron Stevenson, is we're seeing stomach paralysis. It's still in the early phases. Yeah. You know, we're still looking into things. But the doctors, to me, that's the biggest part of this. It's insurance companies are telling them, listen, this is a diabetes drug. This is not a weight loss drug. So what you're doing, doctors, is you're telling these women who come in, who show no signs of diabetes, like, hey, I know you want to lose a little weight here.
Take it for a couple of months.
Yeah, you know
shoot
do
up
this.
For a couple of months.
You'll lose 30, 40 pounds. It's a great
thing. Let me give you another side of the ugly story. In Fen-Phen, women were dying by the hundreds, okay? And even with that, there were still women, even when the product could not be found, taken off the market, women would still search it out, would say, it's so important that I lose weight. You know, rather than pushing yourself away from the table, said, I had enough calories today, let me go exercise some. Rather than doing that, they would seek out a drug that was off the market, and they would try to do black market. Women were actually taking Fen-Phen after it was very clear of how dangerous. I think the first trial had actually taken, it was getting ready to take place. And, you know, the truth is, it's the doctors are taking that truth, that reality, and they're taking advantage of it. And when I say doctors, I'm talking about these clinics. That's where you really see it. You know, just that you would think doctors follow this kind of stuff, but they don't. They have some, you know, little perky, you know, what they call them, detailer, come in with cupcakes, doctor, happy birthday, and they sell a gazillion pills for a little Susie, right? Yeah. The detail process. But so the doctors don't really keep up with the clinical data. They don't really keep up. And that sounds unbelievable. Some of them do, the good ones do. But these clinics are providing such an opportunity for the lawyers that are bringing these cases all over the country because they're going to sue the clinic so they can stay in state court to avoid having to go to federal court.
Yeah, and another thing, too, that we see here is Ozempic, of course, and their very catchy commercials with their little jingle. They're now specifically mentioning you can lose weight on this product. Yeah. And once they say that in the commercial,
it
burns into people's brains. So they say, hey, doc, look, I got the holidays are coming up. I'm going to put on a little weight. Why don't you go ahead and put me on it now?
Yeah.
And the doctors are blindly telling most of these people, okay,
why sure. Hey, push yourself away from the table. Go get some exercise. And do what's right. But here it's, and again, the remarkable thing is when women start seeing other women suffer badly with this, it's not going to make any difference. They're going to say, I'm not going to have that problem. I'm going to take it anyway. Weight loss is more important than my overall health. Farron Cousins, thank you for joining me.
Thank you.